In hexadecimal multiplication, we multiply the two hexadecimal numbers. We have seen earlier in hexadecimal representation that the numbers from 0 through 9 are represented as in decimal numbers, but onwards we use the symbols. As for 10, we use symbol A, for 11 B, for 12 C, for 13 D, for 14 E, and for 15 we use the symbol F. Let us see first example. Let us multiply 43 with 25. These are two hexadecimal numbers. We will do the multiplication as we have already done in decimal numbers multiplication. 43 then multiplied with 35. Let us multiply this digit with first number 5. We know 5 3 is 15, and 15 is equivalent to F. So we will write F here. Then 5 multiplied with 4. 5 4 is 20. Now we know that 20 is greater than 15. So this is not an hexadecimal number. We will convert this number in hexadecimal form. So divide with 16, 16 ones are 16, the remainder is 4. So the equivalent hexadecimal number of 20 is 14. So we will write 14 here. Now we will multiply from this 2, we will put a cross here. Then 2 multiplied by 3 is, this is 2, 3 is 6. Then with 4, 2, 4 is 8. Now we add it. This is F. 4 plus 6 is 10. And we know 10 is represented by A. So we'll write A here. And 8 plus 1 is 9. Now let us take another example. Example second. Let us multiply 8B5 with 43. Write 8B5. This is multiply by 43. First, we'll multiply these all digits with 3. So 3 5s are 15. This is 15, and we know 15 is equal to, symbol of 15 is F. So we'll write F here. Now 3 multiply by B. B is equal to symbol of 10, 11. Now 3 is multiplied by B. B is equivalent of 11. So 11 multiplied by this 3, this is equal to 33. This number is not a hexadecimal number, this is greater than 15. So we will convert this 33 into hexadecimal number and divide it by 16. 16 to the 32, remainder is 1. So the equivalent hexadecimal number will be 21. So we'll put 1 here and 2 carry will be here. Now multiply this 3 with 8. 3 8s are 24. 24 plus 2 is 26. Again we'll convert this 26 into hexadecimal equivalent and divide it into by 16. 16 ones are 16, remainder is 10. So we know this 10 is equivalent to A symbol, so we'll write here 1A. This is equivalent hexadecimal number of this 26, so we'll write 1A here. Now take the second digit, we'll multiply this 4 with all these digits, so put 1 cross here. Multiply this 5 with 4, This is 20. Again, this is not a hexadecimal number. We'll convert it into hexadecimal and divide it by 16. 16 ones are 16. Remainder is 4. So equivalent number is 1, 4. We'll write 4 here and 1 carry here. This is 1 carry. When we multiply it by 3, no carry was here, so we'll take a dash here. Now multiply this 4 with B. We know that B is the symbol of 11, so 11 is multiplied by this 4. This is 44 and 1 is the carry, so total is 55. Again, we will convert this 45 into hexadecimal number. 16 to the 32, remainder is 13. We know that 13 is the symbol of D, so we'll write here 2D, equivalent of this 45. So we'll write D here and 2 carry here. Now multiply this 4 with 8. 8 for the 32. 32 plus 2 is 34. This is 34. Again, we'll convert it into hexadecimal number. 16 to the 32, remainder is 2. So the equivalent number is 22 for this. We'll write 2. Now we'll add these terms. So this is F here. This is 415. Now this is equivalent to 10 and this D is equivalent to 13. So total is 23. And we know 23 is not a hexadecimal number. We convert it into hexadecimal number. 23. 1, remainder is 7. So 17 is the equivalent number. We'll write 7 here and 1 carry will put here. 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, and this is 2. This is the equivalent multiplication of this 2 hexadecimal numbers. Now let us take homework problems. First homework problem: multiply 3a with 15, and second is multiply 2c1 with a5b. If you have any doubt, you can write in comment box. That's all for this presentation. Thank you, friends.